Introduction to Entity Framework. Let's understand what is Entity Framework. So Entity Framework is an ORM framework for .NET. So if you are willing to query your database in object-oriented fashion within your .NET based application, whether it's a WCF, WPF, ASP.NET Web Forms, and ASP.NET MVC, everywhere you can use Entity Framework. So just like the ORM tool, it maps the database tables to a C# or VB.NET object. It depends what the programming language you are willing to use. You can use C# as well as VB.NET, because Entity Framework supports both the languages. So if you are VB.NET developer, you can use the VB.NET style. If you are the C# developer, you can follow the C# style. Entity Framework also provides us the powerful data manipulation API over the mapped schema. So what are the schema we mapped using the C# language, or like using the VB.NET language, so that we can query with the help of the Entity Framework API. So APIs help us to perform the CRUD operation on a particular database table, even to query the data from the database tables here. An Entity Framework uses the link syntax to query the database. So when you talk about the link, so link provides us the common query syntax to query any data source. So data source can be the RDB image, data source can be the your collection, the data source can be the XML. So same style the Entity Framework is following. So if you know the link already, so it look very familiar to you when you write the query within your Entity Framework to query your database. So it uses the familiar syntax. So this is about the Entity Framework. Now let's have a look on the Entity Framework version history. Like when the Entity Framework first version came to the picture, and what is the latest version we have right now. So Entity Framework initially introduced in 2008 with Visual Studio 2008. So we can say it's Entity Framework 1, or you can say the Entity Framework 3.5, because at that time they didn't name it. Then in 2010, with the Visual Studio 10, they introduced the Entity Framework 4.0 with some upgrade features. Like what are the drawback we have in Entity Framework 3.5, because the Entity Framework 1 was very buggy. There was so many issues in the Entity Framework 3.5, but in 4.0 they improved it a lot. Then they introduced the Entity Framework 4.1 in 2011, and in the 4.1 they introduced the code first approach, because initially the Entity Framework was used with database first approach only that was available from its initial release. So the database first approach, it's what easy to map our existing database in the form of XML, and further we can query it. But from 4.1, we have the code style as well. Like now you use C# object, like VB.NET object, to map your database tables. Then they introduced the Entity Framework 5 with some performance improvement as well. Then we have Entity Framework 6 in 2013. Then we have Entity Framework 6.1 with some bug fixing. Then we have Entity Framework 6.2 in 2017. So 6.2 was the last release of the Entity Framework 6.x. And even they are introducing some bug fixing as well. But there is no the new features introduction nowadays. So this is about the Entity Framework version history. So here we are learning about the Entity Framework 6.x. We are not talking about here Entity Framework Core, because Entity Framework Core is altogether a new framework. So in Entity Framework Core, we have the different video series. There you can learn about the Entity Framework Core. Now let's see what are the Entity Framework advantages we have. So the first advantage is it is easy to adopt, because you are already familiar with the C#. You're already familiar with the object-oriented style. So being a C# developer, I can easily pick up. Second is it follows the link common query syntax. So as we use the link to query our collection, to query our generics, same way we can query our database as well. So it's going to simplify the way of writing the query. And the next benefit is it reduces the development time, because now you don't need to write a lot of code for making the connection, for getting the command object, then using the data reader, then opening a loop for reading the value one by one. So a lot of development time we are saving. When you are using the entity framework, because in entity framework only in single line we can query the data from the database, and it is easy to understand as well. So if you are a fresher, so you will find it very easy, because you need to write only few lines of code to perform the crude operation on any database table. But in case of ADO.NET, we need to write a lot of code over there. So generally there the development time is higher than the entity framework. The next benefit is it reduces the development cost as well. So obviously when the development time would be less, so obviously it will impact the cost as well. So it will reduce the cost. So now you need to pay very less if you are using the entity framework to query your database. And the most important benefit of entity framework is it allows us to query the database in object oriented fashion. So you don't need to learn any new style, which you need to learn in case of ADO.NET if you are using. Here the style is similar as we already using with the object oriented languages like C#. And the next benefit is it provides type safety at compile time. So whatever the data you are willing to assign to a C# object, that is going to be checked with the compile time, because the same object is going to map with the database table. So the chances of the runtime type issues are not here as we have in case of ADO.NET. Because in ADO.NET, when we pass the data as a input parameters like anything else, so that time we generally did the mistake. So you might pass the number in place of a string, you might pass the string in place of number. So such errors we get in case of ADO.NET on the runtime. But here everything is going to be corrected on the compile time. So these are the advantages we have about the entity framework. Now let's have a look on the entity framework disadvantages. So obviously every technology has some advantages, some disadvantages if you are comparing it with its successor. So the advantages are here. The performance of entity framework is slow as compared to the ADO.NET. The reason behind this is entity framework is a wrapper around the ADO.NET. So what are the query, what are the things we do in entity framework? Internally it is going to be compiled into the plain SQL, because an RDBMS can understand only T-SQL language. The RDBMS cannot understand the C#. So same way, so that's why it is slow as compared to the ADO.NET performance if you are comparing it. So generally the people didn't recommend the entity framework to use if you are having a big database. Like if you are having the enterprise grade application where you are handling the billions of user, like millions of user, like where you are having, let's say, the thousand of tables. So there the people generally avoid to use entity framework because of its performance issue. But if you are having a medium size application, a smaller size application, their entity framework will save your time a lot. So this is about the entity framework. I hope now you have the clear picture what is entity framework, what are the various advantages and disadvantages we are having.